Hey everyone, this is Thomas here. Today, I'm going to switch things up a bit and touch on a topic that is not necessarily finance or investment related, but I guarantee it's going to be an interesting one. I want to share how to let someone to understand and agree with your plan. This is going to be useful to you in building relationships, no matter if this is between you and your clients, your friends, or your families. Once you understand it, it becomes a powerful tool for others to understand and commit to the agreement. Let's get started. As you guys probably know, I do a lot of one-on-one consultation, and one thing that's quite bothering me is that some people will always reschedule at the last minute or just no shows. They ran through the trouble to reserve a time slot with me and they ditched. So I always wonder, is it because my message is not clear or they have a more pressing matter? And not too long ago, I was attending a business event and came across Dr. Neha Sanwang's presentation. And the topic is called Unraveling Unclear Agreements. And immediately, I thought it would be interesting to share this knowledge with other people. Dr. Neha is an internal medicine physician, international speaker, and corporate communication expert. She provides corporate leaders and their team members with tools for clear and effective communication. Corporations that consult with her include American Express and Google, which makes it no surprise that she's a regular TED Talk speaker and share how to excel under pressure. If you're interested in finding out more about her work, I'll provide a link down below. What you and I will encounter every day, and that is making agreements. Small agreements like who you want to spend your lunchtime with, or something bigger like who will you trust with your money. So, as long as you work with or live with another person, making agreements is something that you cannot be avoided. This is very important because the quality of your agreement is going to determine the quality of your relationships. Cumulative choices around agreements are going to contribute greatly around the satisfaction you feel in your life. And Dr. Neha breaks it down into 5 levels of agreements. Let's say you're about to ask the girl you're dating to see the new Batman movie. Hey Winnie, do you want to go see the new Batman movie this weekend? And Winnie responds, oh, I didn't even know it's out already. Do you think you guys have an agreement right there? That's correct. No, you guys don't have an agreement, because all she did was simply acknowledge you, but she hasn't given you an answer whether she wants to go or not. Now, what if she responds, oh, I've been dying to see this movie since we last saw the trailer. Now, do you think you have an agreement? Again, not really, because all she did was showing some positive interest. But you guys still don't have an agreement yet. Now imagine if she responds this way instead. Yes, I absolutely want to go see the movie with you this weekend, if I can get my assignment done. Do you guys have an agreement now? You think you got a date, but not quite. This is a level 3 agreement and it's called a qualified yes. You might have encountered this a lot throughout your life, and a lot of people tend to respond this way, because it gives them a backdoor out. Winnie could easily say to you 3 hours before the showtime, hey Thomas, I couldn't get my assignment done in time, why don't you go ahead with the movie with someone else? If you think you have an agreement with her, you're probably gonna feel fed up and have a huge disappointment. Now let's continue with a level 4 example. Winnie responds to you, yes, I do want to see it, let's do it. Do we have an agreement? To most people, they will say yes, this is absolutely an agreement, but not to Dr. Neha. Even though it's a clear yes, it doesn't tell where and when you're going to see the movie. Basically, there are no details confirmed whatsoever. Finally, Winnie responds to you like this. Yes, Thomas, I would love to see it. How about the 1 p.m. show this Saturday at Richmond Silver City? I buy popcorn and you buy tickets? Now, do we have an agreement? Yes, finally! This is the kind of agreement that Dr. Neha is talking about, because it has all the details confirmed and is very clear and has no ambiguity. Now here's the big question. You might be asking, then should we all aim to achieve level 5 agreement in everything? Does it mean only level 5 agreements are good and the rest sucks? And the answer is no. There's no right or wrong levels of agreement actually. As long as both people are at the same level of agreement, then things will go smoothly and there will be no conflicts. Conflicts and disappointments are only arise when two people are at different levels of agreement. think about the time when your mom yelled to you, "Go clean your room," and respond, "Okay." Then 3 hours later, when she found out your room was still messy, and she got really upset, because you were actually giving her a level 4 agreement when your mom was probably thinking that was a level 5 agreement. Think about the other time when you're really partying and you strike up with a conversation with someone that you newly met. You find out that you and her are both interested in hiking. So you suggest to her, "Oh, we should go hiking sometime." And your new friend responds, "Yeah, that would be fun." You guys both show positive interest and were at level 2 agreements. Whether or not you guys would actually go for a hike someday is not important. What's important here is that you guys were both at the same level agreement and you guys will get along smoothly. So this brings us to my next point. What should you do if you notice you are at a different level agreement with someone? Let's use another movie example. Say Ashley and Betty have lost contact for years and they just reconnected. Ashley suggested to Betty that they should go out for this new movie and catch up this Saturday. Betty responds, "Yeah, for sure, as long as I can get someone to watch the kids when I'm in." So right away, Ashley recognizes that Betty is a level 3 agreement and she likes to have a level 5 commitment instead. How do you think Ashley should proceed in her decision making? In this case, Ashley should ask herself what she values in this agreement. And it depends on the motive. If she really wants to see this new movie on the first weekend before other people, then she should try to neither find another people to go with or go solo. However, if Ashley values to just connect with Betty, then she can provide another option to Betty by saying, "How about I bring dinner over to you, and that way you don't have to look for childcare." By providing an alternative to Betty, it will likely help close the gap between the different levels of agreements between Ashley and Betty. To sum it up, when you recognize what levels of agreement you got, and then you realize the other person is at a different level of agreement, the way you move to quick and clear decision making is by knowing what you value about that agreement, what matters beneath it, what's driving it, and that's how you will know. And say if you're someone that is offering a product or service, like a real estate agent or a coach, next time you know what product or service your client values and what goals they are trying to achieve, and they are at a different level of agreement from yours, then you can ask the right question to close the gap. Or at least, this will help you filter the unwanted prospects. And this will also help you to communicate with your other half as well. And again, if you want to know more about being better in communication and management, I will leave Dr. Neha's detail in the description box below. But before you leave, you can give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See? Levels of agreement. Alright, thanks so much for watching. This is Thomas, and I will see you in the next video.